I think when buying a property for the first time, there's so many legal consequences and obligation each buyer and seller has. For our first-time buyers, it's important that they firstly know the costs involved in buying property. I know that doesn't relate to the offer to purchase, but I want to emphasize that first, because buying property is expensive. And part of that offer to purchase process is the financed part of it. And you need available liquid cash in order for a transfer to go through at the deeds office, to go towards the attorney costs as well as transfer duty to the receiver of revenue. So they need to make sure when entering into that agreement, whether there's an estate agent involved or they're doing it privately, that they have liquid cash available to cover the costs. Another thing that's very important, and I think in entering into any sale agreement, is the footstoots clause. Everyone's heard of the footstoots clause at some stage of their lives, whether that's buying a car, buying movable property, but it's very, very much applicable in once-off sales, and it's a protection that that's provided to the seller, and it's for all your latent and patent defects. So once you enter into that agreement and your offer is put before the seller, you must have done all your homework in and around that property. Patent and latent defects. Patents are the ones you can see with the naked eye. Latents are only discovered at a later stage, but both fall under the footstoots clause. And I think what's quite important there is that you're buying a property at a certain price in the condition that it's in. So very important that you ensure you know exactly what you're buying. I think that's an important part of the process. Then in buying in sectional title and gated estates, I want to emphasize this because I see it more and more each day, is you buy in to that estate's rules and regulations and that sectional scheme's management and conduct rules. So it's important that you've glanced over those documents before entering into that offer to purchase. I'm going to give you an example. We recently did a transaction where the management and conduct rules weren't read by the client, who's a dog lover, and this particular scheme had a no pet policy. And so you can see the consequences involved in trying to now escape that deal, and they were tied in, they had to buy the property and then sell it on, making a loss. So very important that they've understood what product they're actually buying, because once you've entered into that agreement, it's fully enforceable and you can be sued for damages if you later try and escape the deal or cancel the deal.